This is our third video on optics and will involve both the reflection and refraction of light. When light from a substance with a certain index of refraction encounters another substance with a different index of refraction, both reflection and refraction of light typically occur, a situation we will refer to as partial reflection, but it could also be called partial refraction. Partial reflection can be easily seen in blackboard optics when a laser beam is sent toward a block of glass with an angle of incidence of 30 degrees. One can see a refracted component bending toward the normal as it enters the medium with the larger index of refraction. One can also observe a faint reflected component obeying the law of reflection. Some of the light is transmitted and some is reflected. Note that our perception of the brightness of the beam gives us a crude indication of the percentages of light that are reflected and transmitted. The exact values depend upon the indices of refraction of the two substances and also upon the angle of incidence. Let's check your intuition related to partial reflection from everyday life. If we increase the angle of incidence, what will happen to the brightness of the reflected ray? Classroom students should follow normal procedures or instructor guidelines. Viewers not in a classroom should record your vote and explain your reasoning on a piece of paper. Please pause this video and answer the question. Note that as we increase the angle of incidence, we can see that the brightness of the reflected ray, the percentage of reflected light, increases. Many surfaces, like tile floors and bodies of water, that reflect very little when the angle of incidence is small, reflect very well when the angle of incidence is very large. An interesting application of this is light coming through a glass window. During the day, incoming light from the bright outside is largely transmitted. You can see the outside. At night, when it is dark outside, there is little light coming in, and you can easily see your reflection. That reflection is there during the day as well. When light at normal incidence encounters glass, about 4% of the light is reflected, and 96% is transmitted at each surface. However, in this situation, the 8% of light from inside the lighted room that is reflected back from the window is quite a bit brighter than the 92% of light from the darkness outside that is transmitted through the window. When we place a light bulb between two plates of glass, an infinite number of images are seen. Keep in mind that every time light encounters glass, 8% of the light is reflected and some is refracted. Note how the brightnesses of the images decrease when more reflections have occurred. As another example of this phenomenon, let's look at a PepperGram. It is a thin plastic plate that can be folded into an inverted pyramid. Note that the four-sided inverted pyramid has sides that are angled at about 45 degrees to the base. It is placed on a smartphone or tablet, and a special YouTube video with four-sided symmetry is played, creating something that looks like a hologram as the four images are brought together to a common focus. Here is an example of one of the many four-sided videos available on YouTube. A demonstration built more completely upon the principle of partial reflection is Pepper's Ghost. This dates back to the 1800s time period when illusions were explained away as "it's all smoke and mirrors." We look in and see our reflection, as there is a mirror in the back of the apparatus. However, the joke goes that there is an X-ray machine mounted in the top of the apparatus, and we can turn it on and see your skeleton. Of course, there is no X-ray machine. The secret to this is partial reflection. There is a plate of glass at a 45 degree angle in the center, and note that it is dark inside the apparatus. The plate is often referred to as half-silvered. It has a coating applied to it which causes 92% of the light from your face to pass through the 45 degree plate and hit the mirror at the back and then reflect back to you. Note that there is also a lighted skeleton mask mounted into the ceiling. When it is turned on, its light heads toward the 45 degree plate, so we see the lighted ceiling mask. The principles of partial reflection show up in devices called interferometers. The incoming beam of light is split into two paths, some refracted, some reflected. The two beams hit mirrors and are eventually recombined. Their combined light is useful for learning about either the original light or the distance along one of the beam paths. As an example of this, here is an interferometer that is used to measure the wavelength of light. We see the interference fringes where the combined light from the two paths alternates between constructive and destructive interference. We can measure the change in position of one of the mirrors that will move the pattern of fringes through one complete cycle, which corresponds to half the wavelength of light. More teaching materials can be found on the web at astro.unl.edu.